Welcome to the Game Gengo JLPT N3 Grammar Series. In this video, we're going to be covering four pieces of grammar. Buri ni, chu, and ju, betsu ni nai, and dake. In this video, we will break down the grammar so you can see exactly how it's used and get a complete picture of the grammar, but we'll also have multiple different game examples from many different games so that you can get a really strong context of how the piece of grammar is used. This video is brought to you by all the supporters on Patreon, so if you want to support the channel, please feel free to join us on Patreon. So, without further ado, let's get into the video.
<笑>
Here we have the piece of grammar, buri ni. And very simply, this is used with nouns that express a kind of measurement of time. And this expresses doing something for the first time in that extent of time. Like seen here in Uncharted, they have discovered a place for the first time in 300 years. 300年 buri ni. So you can see here that the time in which it's the first time in comes first, followed by buri ni, and then followed by the action that you're doing for the first time in that period of time. Let's take a look at some other examples to get a stronger feel for how this piece of grammar is used. So in these examples, we saw for the first time in 7 years, for the first time in 3 years, for the first time in 2 years, and for the first time in a while. So in all of these examples, you can see that it's often used with a period of time, whether it's a certain amount of years, a certain amount of months, any kind of time. However, we can also see that the phrase hisashiburi, this is also the same thing. Hisashi means a long time, buri for the first time in, so for the first time in a long time. So hisashiburi is actually an expression to say that this is the first time in long period of time, not a specific point in time like 300年, but just in a period of a long time. And that is how buri ni is used.
Sate Ragnar-kun, akogare no Julia no toujou da na. Konya koso itte miyou ka? Hora ike yo.
Nani itten da yo? Julia wa shigoto chuu da ze.
This next piece of grammar can often be seen in kanji, like in this example. However, it actually has two different uses and meanings, as well as pronunciation. So make sure to pay attention to what kind of language it's attached to in order to know the correct use. First, chu. This is used at a time something is taking place. Several potential examples for this use with chu could be currently or during something. So, like seen here in Final Fantasy VIII, Laguna here is wanting to talk to Julia, however, she's in the middle of work. Shigoto chu. So we can see here that the chu is expressing being in the middle of an action, and that action is shigoto. Shigoto chu, in the middle of work. So we can see that this first use is used to say during or currently. But there's a second use here that we can see, ju. Now, ju can be used a little bit differently. We have these last two expressions, throughout and before the end of. This is more how the ju reading is used, whether throughout an area or before the end of a certain period of time. Let's take a look at some further examples and we can get a really strong feel for how both of these different uses are used.
Hey!
どこ見てんだ。試合中だぜ、お嬢さん。
セーブ中です。電源ボタンに触らないでください。
バカな、ステルス航行中だぞ。ゲスの船に見つかるはずは。
あれはゲスじゃない。
回避行動。
ようやく解放されたと思ったら体中が痛く。
一人でここまで来たの？
ううん、潮立てまではお父さんの車で来たんだ。でもお父さん、今日中に東京まで帰らなきゃいけないから、さっき潮立ての港でさよならしてきたんだ。
So we saw for the first one, 中, we can see 仕事中, during work, 試合中, in the middle of a match, セーブ中, in the middle of saving,And even Koko too, in the middle of navigation. So this first use is quite clear, right? Something is in progress. You're in the middle of doing something. Then we have the next use, which is ju. Now, we saw in the first example, karada ju. And this means throughout. So throughout your body, itaku, they hurt. So we can see here that throughout one's body, they're hurting. Karada ju.So here the ju is following the thing that is throughout. And you could use this, for example, a place, right? Like in Final Fantasy, you would have Midogaru ju, throughout Midgar. The other use that we can see here is before the end of. Like here in Boku no Natsuyasumi, we saw Kyoju ni, dun dun dun. This means before the end of today. So kyo is today, followed by ju, that means before the end of,and then the thing following. So we can see here that this ju is a little bit more difficult to use than chu. Chu is very simple, it just means something's in progress. However, ju could be throughout something, or even before the end of something.
仲間のために死ぬことこそ、剣士の本望なのであろう。
仲間？
仲間？そうだよ、僕たちもう仲間だよ。
別に我はそういう意味で言ったわけでは。
じゃあどういう意味で言ったの？
それは。
Here we have an incredibly simple piece of grammar, 別に followed by a verb, noun or adjective in the nai form to simply mean not particularly or not really, whatever the following verb, noun or adjective is. Like for example, 別に難しいことではない。It's not particularly a difficult thing.Or even like seen here in Near Replicant. So here in this example sentence, we can see 別に followed by nai. However, in this sentence, the nai has been cut off because he's been interrupted. So this full sentence would be そういう意味でいたわけではない. So it's not that I meant to say it in that way, right? And 別に means not particularly.So that's not particularly what I meant. So we can see that it's used to not particularly...something, right? Not particularly difficult, not particularly what I meant. Let's have a look at some other examples to get a stronger feel for how it's used.
どうするつもりだ？
別にどうもしない。
なんだと？
斉藤、どうかしたの？
いや、別に何でもない。
あれ？
やっぱ学校か。別に変わったとこなかったよな。
So all of these examples are quite similar, really. We have 別にどうもしない。Nothing in particular means I'm not going to do anything in particular. Then we have 別に何でもない. That means it is nothing in particular. And then lastly, we have there's nothing particular unusual about it. 別に変わったことはない. So we can see that it's used with a negative form to say it's not particularly whatever it is you're talking about. Whether you don't particularly have anything planned, you're not particularly doing anything in particular, or that's not particularly what you meant to say.
二人を連れてできるだけ遠くへ離れてくれ。頼んだぞ、ピッコロ。
Now we have what at first appears to be a very familiar piece of language that we've already actually learnt at the N5 level for only or just. However, this time, it actually takes on a completely different meaning. Dake here, when following a verb, noun, or adjective, is used to mean as much as. Like, do as much as you can. Dekiru dake yaru. Or eat as much as you want. Tabetai dake tabete. So we can see that it follows a verb, noun, or adjective to say as much as that, and then the action that you do follows. So eat as much as you want. Tabetai would be want to eat. Dake as much as. Tabete eat. So this piece of grammar takes a little bit of getting used to. So let's have a look at a bunch of different game examples so you can get a really strong feel for how it's used.
この都市には帝国に立ち向かうだけの力がある。
俺の体にこれだけ深く剣を打ち込んだ人間は貴様が初めてだ。
何をしてる腰抜け。奴らのセンサーが狂う。その隙にできるだけ遠くへ。
あれだけの力があれば人生はもうバラ色であろうな。
エンジンシールド一つ破壊するどれだけの火力が必要なのか。
Okay, great. So let's have a look at a bit of a summary of how dake is used to mean as much as. So in the first example we had dekiru dake, as much as you can. Then we had tachimukau dake no chikara. That means as much power to be able to stand up to someone. Then we had kore dake, as much as this. Again, dekiru dake, as much as you can.Are dake, as much as that, and then finally, dore dake, how much. So we can see that all of these uses is talking about a certain extent of doing something. Whether the extent that you can do, dekiru dake, the extent to be able to stand up to someone, the extent of this, the extent of that, to what extent. We can see here that dake means as much as.So that's it for yet another JLPT N3 grammar video. So how did you guys go? Some of these grammar were quite interesting. Some of them are a little bit difficult to get used to, especially as they have similar readings to other things that you may have learned, but they take on this new meaning, right? Especially chu and ju and dake, for example.So, hopefully this video has helped you guys enjoy learning Japanese. As always, thank you very much for watching. A huge thank you to all of the supporters on Patreon. If you like learning Japanese with the channel, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe. And hey, join us on Patreon if you want to hang out in the Discord community. As always, thank you very much, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.